Today on AI News, a game changer bigger than vibe coding has arrived, plus a first look at a new humanoid robot. But first, MagicBot just debuted its brand new open-source humanoid robot named the Z1 Development Edition with several upgrades, so what kind of hardware is it packing? Standing at 1,369mm tall or about 4.5 feet, the Z1 form factor is sturdy enough to take a beating and keep working. On top of this, the robot is compact enough that when folded, its height drops to 730mm, or just about 2.4 feet for increased portability. As for the robot's weight, it's about 40 kilograms including its battery. Furthermore, the Z1 Development Edition offers up to 50 degrees of freedom through its joint motors, with each leg featuring 6 degrees of freedom for maximum range of motion, plus additional options for dexterous hands and wrists. As for toughness, the robot's industrial-grade spherical output bearing can withstand impacts up to 8,700 newtons, matched by joint motors capable of producing up to 130 newton-meters of torque. Next, each arm can manage loads up to 3 kilograms thanks to the robot's onboard 15-cell, 10,000 mAh smart battery, which provides about 2 hours of continuous operation, with the option to swap out. And the Z1's connectivity is comprehensive, including Wi-Fi 6, Bluetooth 5.2, a microphone array, plus a 5-watt speaker for interaction. And when it comes to environmental awareness, the robot is equipped with a suite of perception sensors, including 3-dimensional LiDAR, a depth camera, and a binocular fisheye camera, offering 360-degree perception for efficient navigation and obstacle avoidance. As for compute, it packs an optional Jetson Orin module to boost its onboard computing power, with the robot being open source for community-driven development. But when it comes to cost, the price tag is still unknown, so make sure to share in the comments what you'd be willing to pay. Meanwhile, RobotEra just previewed its newest Q5 humanoid robot with upgraded dexterity, design, and intelligence. But what can it do now? To start, the Q5 is designed to be a general humanoid robot that can function in both home and work environments. But its standout feature is a 7-axis arm with 11 degrees of freedom in each of its hands, enabling agile and precise manipulation. Plus, the Q5's human-sized hands can carry up to 10 kilograms each, while achieving rapid response rates of 10 clicks per second. On top of this, the Q5 is enhanced by micro-force control joints that allow it to excel in tasks requiring both power and delicate precision. And the Q5's design is compact enough to easily navigate confined spaces or narrow paths. To do this, it features an advanced navigation system that uses both 3D LiDAR and binocular camera vision to enable autonomous movement and sharp environmental awareness in complex settings. This also makes the Q5 ideal for dynamic environments. But interaction is the cornerstone of the Q5's design. Its hyperanthropomorphic form, lifelike appearance, and unique waist structure are meant to foster more natural human-robot exchanges. Supporting anthropomorphic dialogue, the Q5 can engage in intuitive communication. And for long distance, the robot also offers synchronized whole-body teleoperation, which is compatible with data gloves, VR, and other remote control technologies, making it perfect for applications like remote assistance and hazardous environment operations. And because it's powered by RobotEra's Era AI platform, a comprehensive embodied AI system, the Q5 integrates seamlessly with other smart devices for enhanced functionality. When it comes to the robot's price tag, this information is yet to be released, but the intention to bring general-purpose humanoid robots into homes and offices as soon as possible is loud and clear. And in AI building, the power of context engineering is far superseding the power of vibe coding. And who better to inspire it than the co-founder of OpenAI, Andrei Karpathy? But what exactly is context engineering? Picture this. Instead of writing rigid code or throwing vague prompts at an AI, context engineering is about crafting the perfect environment, prompts, data, and constraints to make AI behave exactly how you want. And at the heart of this idea is Andrei Karpathy, the AI pioneer who's been shaping how machines think with his work at Tesla, OpenAI, and beyond. So here's the step-by-step walkthrough showing you how to start context engineering right now, for free, without even needing to code. Now enter context engineering, which takes the playful, intuitive spirit of vibe coding, where you nudge AI with prompts and turns it into a precise creative science. So, how do we actually start context engineering? Here's a breakdown of its 5 key components. First up is prompt structuring. This is about crafting detailed multi-part prompts that leave no guesswork, like by using a product requirements document, or PRD, a blueprint for programming that defines a system's goals, features, and limits, like the purpose, required functions, performance metrics, and safety rules. For example, a PRD for a warehouse robot system would specify which backend to use, which transformer AI architecture it employs, how many packages per hour need to be sorted, how large the warehouse is, and so on. This step is all about providing crystal clear instructions and constraints. Next, there's contextual data injection. This is the step where the AI is fed curated examples or datasets. Karpathy's work on fine-tuning models like his early ConvNet.js library shows how feeding the right example data can drastically enhance performance. Third, there's environmental design. This is where you define the AI's role. In this step, you shape its perspective. Karpathy's talks on role-based prompting highlight how this trick can unlock wildly creative yet focused results. Fourth, there's iterative refinement. Because context engineering isn't just a one-and-done process, you'll need to analyze the AI's output, tweak your context, and try again. This feedback achieves increasingly precise results over time to steer the AI towards its goals. And finally, there's constraint layering. This is where you set boundaries and restrictions to keep the AI on track. This can be done by adding rules to maintain maximum control over the design. And in generative AI, HeyGen just launched its groundbreaking video agent as a powerful new AI tool to revolutionize end-to-end video production. Incredibly, by simply uploading a document, raw footage, or a single sentence, users can now create professional-grade videos in minutes. On top of this, their video agent not only autonomously writes scripts and selects or generates the necessary visuals, but it also handles editing, including transitions and captions, to streamline the entire content creation process. At the same time, for software engineers and vibe coders alike, Replit just released its dynamic intelligence-powered agent to enhance AI-powered coding, enabling builders to tackle complex tasks with advanced generative AI. Featuring extended thinking, high-power models, and web search, it tackles complex tasks like app performance optimization. Furthermore, the agent now reasons step-by-step, delivering precise solutions with minimal input. Ideal for developers, it navigates tough challenges, from debugging to UI redesigns, making coding faster and smarter. And finally, AGI Bot has recently demonstrated two new robots coming to its lineup, with the first being the Lingxi X2 with five-fingered hands and the ability to use various tools and objects intelligently thanks to its Genie Operator 1 model. This robot features 28 degrees of freedom and is trained with over 1 million trajectories with Go1's vision language action framework linking the robot's three-dimensional vision to precise actions in order to master dynamic skills and environments. But the second humanoid robot coming to AGI Bot's lineup is the recently revealed X2N, which has wheels that turn into feet to allow the robot to both roll and climb. But not much more is known about this robot so far, so tell us how much you think it will cost in the comments below.